Today, we're diving into the world of Metasploit, a powerful tool that's widely used in penetration testing and ethical hacking. But before we begin, it's crucial to remember that the information provided in this video is meant for educational purposes and ethical use only. If you enjoy this type of content, make sure you like the video. Now, let's get started. Metasploit is a comprehensive tool that offers numerous functionalities for penetration testers and ethical hackers, like exploiting vulnerabilities, creating malicious payloads, and even evading detection. It's essentially a collection of utilities bundled into one software suite. Firstly, you need to have Metasploit installed on your system. I am using Kali Linux, which comes pre-installed with Metasploit. If you don't have it installed, there are many online resources available to guide you through the installation process. To launch Metasploit, open your terminal and type MSF console. This will bring up the Metasploit framework console. It may take a minute to load. The MSF prompt is where we will enter all our commands. The first command you should know is help. This will show a list of available command parameters. You can use help followed by any command to get more detailed information about that command. The search command is useful for finding specific modules. For example, we can search for a specific exploit or payload. Let's try searching for an FTP server exploit by typing search FTP. You'll see a list of available exploits related to FTP servers. If we want to use one of them, we can use the use command followed by the path of the exploit. Now that we've selected an exploit, we need to set it up. We can view the options for our chosen exploit by typing show options. Here we can see the parameters we need to set to use this exploit. The set command allows us to define these parameters. Once the necessary parameters are set, we can launch the exploit with the run command. The final step is to launch the exploit. Please remember, you should only run this on systems you have permission to test. That's a basic introduction to Metasploit, and you are now familiar with the most used commands. There's so much more to explore and learn, but I hope this gives you a solid start. In future videos, we'll delve into more complex functionalities of Metasploit. Don't forget to like if you found this video helpful and let me know in the comments what you want me to cover next. Thanks for watching, and make sure you check out these related videos.